Good morning, students, and welcome to today's class. So in the last class, we studied subtraction of three-digit numbers without regrouping. Then we saw how to do regrouping of ones and regrouping of tens. Correct? So in today's class, we'll learn regrouping of tens and ones both together. So before that, let's do a quick revision on what we did in the last class. So first, we did subtraction of three-digit numbers in the last class. Correct? So here we saw it with an example. Subtract 768 minus 53. So first, what you do, you always line up the ones, tens and hundreds, one below the other. So first you write the larger number. So the larger number here is 768. So 8 is in ones place, 6 in tens and 7 in hundreds. Correct? Then we have 53. Now here 3 we have in ones place and 5 in tens place. We don't have any digit in hundreds place. Now we have done the first step, that is lining up the ones, tens and hundreds one below the other. Now what you do, you always start subtracting the from the ones. Okay, we always start subtracting from ones. So first we will subtract 8 ones minus 3 ones. What we'll get? We'll get 5 ones. Okay, we get 5 ones. So we'll write 5 in the ones column. The next we subtract the tens, that is 6 tens minus 5 tens, which is 1. Okay, 6 minus 5 is 1. So we write 1 in the tens column. Then finally subtract the hundreds. Now 7 minus nothing, there is no digit, so we can consider it as 0. So 7 minus 0 is 7 only. So we write 7 in the hundreds column. So what is 768 minus 53? It is 715. Okay, and we saw various questions on subtraction of 3 digit numbers. Correct? Now let's revise how to do regrouping for subtracting by ones. Okay, first what we do, as usual, you arrange the numbers one below the other. Okay, so first we'll write 352. So 2 in ones, 5 in tens and 3 in hundreds place. Then 135, 5 in ones, 3 in tens and 1 in hundreds place. Okay, then we, as usual, start subtracting from the ones. So here we have 2 ones minus 5 ones. Okay, since you cannot take away 5 from 2, so what we do, change 1 ten of 5 tens to 10 ones. Or else we are borrowing 1 ten from the tens place. So here in tens place I have 5. So I'll borrow 1 from 5. What happens when I borrow 1 from 5? This 5 becomes 4 and this 2 ones that are there in ones place becomes 12 ones. Okay, 110 is equal to 10 ones. So 10 ones plus 2 ones is 12 ones. Okay, so now we have 12 ones minus 5 ones, which is equal to 7 ones. So we write 7 in the ones column. Then we subtract the tens. So for subtracting tens, what we do? We took away 110 from 5, so we have 4 left, correct? So 4 minus 3 is 1. Okay, so we'll write 1 in the tens column. Then in hundreds we have 300 minus 100. So 3 minus 1 is 2. So we write 2 in the hundreds place. Then next we saw, so the answer 352 minus 135 is 217. Okay, so next we saw regrouping for subtracting tens. Correct, we saw how to do regrouping for subtracting tens. So here they have told subtract 745 minus 462. So previously we studied how to regroup only for ones. Now we are studying how to regroup for subtracting tens. So first subtract the ones first, then tens. Okay, so first, as usual, we write the numbers in their columns according to their place values. Then we start subtracting from 1. So here we have 5 ones minus 2 ones. So how much is 5 minus 2? 5 minus 2 is 3. So we write 3 in ones place. Then here we have in tens place 4 tens minus 6 tens. But we cannot take 6 tens from 4 tens because 4 is smaller than 6. So what we'll do, we'll borrow 100 from the hundreds place. So in hundreds place we have 7. Correct, so I'll borrow 100 from this 7. So when I borrow 100 from this 7, this 4 tens what are there becomes 14 tens. Okay, so 14 tens minus 6 tens is 8. Okay, so we'll write 8 in tens column. Now in hundreds column, since I took away 100 from 7, 6 will be left. Okay, so now we have 6 minus 4, which is 2. So we write 2 in hundreds column. So here 745 minus 462 is 283. Okay, so this was regrouping for subtracting tens. So today we are going to study how to do regrouping for subtracting both tens and ones. Okay, so here in the example they have given 920 minus 248. So first what we'll do, we'll write the numbers in their place value. So 920, the 0 is in ones place, 2 in tens, 9 in hundreds. Okay, minus 248, so 248, 8 is in ones, 4 in tens and 2 in hundreds column. Okay, now what we'll do is, we'll subtract 920 minus 248. So we'll start subtracting from ones. Now there is 0 in the ones place here, correct? 0 minus 8, we cannot take away 8 from 0. So what we'll do, we change 110, okay? So we'll borrow 110 from tens place. Now in tens place, I have 2 tens. So from this 2 tens, I will borrow 110. So when I borrow 110, this 0 that is there plus 10 ones which we borrowed becomes 10. So here now I have 10 ones minus 8 ones, which is 2. Okay, now since I borrowed 110 from 2, we'll be left with 1. Now I cannot do 1 minus 4 because I cannot take away 4 tens from 110. So what we'll do now, we'll borrow 100 from 900s. Okay, so this I borrow 100 from 900s. So this 110 becomes 11 tens. Okay, so 11 minus 4 is how much? 11 minus 4 is 7. Then this 900s that is there, since we are borrowing 100 from 900, this 9 becomes 8. Okay, so 8 minus 2 is 6. So what we got here? We got 672. Okay, let's do it again. So there is 0 in the ones place. Correct? So change 110 of 2 tens to 10 ones. Okay, I'm borrowing 110 from tens place, which becomes 10 ones. So 10 ones minus 8 ones is 2 ones. So we are left with 110 in the tens place. Since 110 is smaller than 4 tens, we regroup the hundreds and borrow 100. Okay, so 100 is equal to 10 tens. Correct? So 10 tens plus this 110 becomes 11 ten. So 11 minus 4 is 7. So write 7 here. Then we are now left with 9 minus 1, 800 is here. So 8 minus 2 is 6. So what is the answer here? 672. Okay, so this is how you do regrouping for subtracting both tens and ones. Now, so when you subtract two numbers, you can often check if your subtraction is correct by doing the reverse process of addition. So when they ask you to subtract two numbers and then check your answer, what you will do first, you will subtract the two numbers. So here they have subtracted 75 minus 36. Okay, so when I subtract, I got the answer as 39. So to check if your answer of 39 is correct, what we do, we'll add this 39. So we'll take this 39 here. We'll do this answer 39 plus we'll add 36. So between 75 and 36, 36 is the smaller number. So we'll add 39 plus 36. So 9 plus 6 is 15. So we write 5 and carry over 1. So 1 plus 3, 4 and 4 plus 3, 7. So what we got? We got 75. Now if you see here, 75 is the larger number over here. Correct? So when you add the difference, that is your answer, to the smaller number, or it is called the smaller number, you should get the larger number as the answer. It means then your subtraction is right. So we'll do a few problems, then you'll understand how to do it. Okay, so let's solve a few questions that are there in your textbook. Okay, so page number 121 in your textbook. So practice time, subtract the following, one has been done for you. Okay, so they have done 724 minus 428. So 4 minus 8 you can't do, so you'll borrow 1 from the next place, that is 10th place. So this 2 which is there in 10th place becomes 1, and this 4 becomes 14. So 14 minus 8 is 6, so we'll write 6 in 1's place. Okay, then in 10th place I have, since I borrowed 1 from 2, 1 is left. So 1 minus 2, I cannot do 1 minus 2, so what we'll do now, we'll borrow 100 from 100th place. So in 100th place we have 7, so this 7 becomes 6. And in 10th place we have 11 now. So 11 minus 2 is 9. And in 100th place 6 minus 4 is 2. So the answer here is 296. Okay. So let's do the B1. Now 745 minus 368. Okay. So first what we'll do, 5 ones minus 8 ones. So we cannot do that because 5 is smaller than 8. So what we'll do, we'll borrow 1 from the 10th place. Now in 10th place we have 4. So when I borrow 1, this 5 ones that are there becomes 15 ones. Okay, so 15 minus 8 is how much? 15 minus 8 is 7. Okay, 15 minus 8 is 7. So we'll write 7 in ones place. Now here we have, since we borrowed 1 from 4, this becomes 4 minus 1, 3. So we have 3 left here. Now we cannot do 3 minus 6. Can we do it? No. So what we'll do is, we'll borrow 100 from 7. So here 7 becomes 6, and this 3 tens that are there becomes 13 tens. Okay, it becomes 13 tens. So how much is 13 minus 6? 13 minus 6 is 7. Okay, 13 minus 6 is 7. Then hundreds place we have 6 minus 3, 3. So here we have 377 as the answer. Okay, first answer is 377. Then next one, 850 minus 387. Now what we'll do, 0 is there here in ones place, so we cannot do subtraction. So we'll borrow 1 from 10th place. So this 5 in 10th place becomes 4, and this becomes 10. So 10 minus 7. How much is 10 minus 7? 10 minus 7 is 3. So we'll write 3 in ones place. Now 4 minus 8. We cannot do 4 minus 8. So what we'll do? We'll borrow 100 from 100th place. In 100th place, we have 8. So this becomes 7. Okay, and this 4 tens becomes 14 tens. So 14 minus 8. How much is 14 minus 8? 14 minus 8 is 6. So we'll write 6 in tens place. Then in hundreds place, we have 7 minus 3. 7 minus 3 is 4. So we'll write 463 over here. So the answer here is 463. Now similarly, you all do the problems D, E and F for your homework. Okay, do these three questions for your homework. Alright. So now, hope you'll have done the first two and hope you've understood it. So complete this for your homework. Now we'll do the next questions on the next page. Okay, so do these sums, then check your answer. So here they have told you to do the subtraction and then check your answers also. So first they have done 735 minus 258. Okay, so when they have subtracted, they've got the answer as 477. So to check their answers, what they have done 477, that is your answer, plus your smallest number. So that is 258. 477 plus 258 gives you 735, which is the bigger number here. Okay, so it means your answer is correct. So let's solve few problems. Now, 5 minus 3. How much is 5 minus 3? 5 minus 3 is 2. So we'll write 2 over here. Then 8 minus 4. How much is 8 minus 4? 8 minus 4 is 4. And 6 minus 2. How much is 6 minus 2? 6 minus 2 is also 4. So we'll write 4 here. So we have 442 as the answer. Correct. So to check your answer, what you'll do? You'll write 442 here first. Okay, you'll write your answer 442. Then what you'll do, you'll write the smallest number, which is 243. Okay, 243. Now we'll add 442 plus 243. Now, how much is 2 plus 3? 2 plus 3 is 5, correct? 2 plus 3 is 5. Then, 4 plus 4, how much is 4 plus 4? 4 plus 4 is 8. And then, 4 plus 2 is how much? 4 plus 2 is 6. So, our answer is 685, which is the larger number over here, 685. So, our answer 442 is correct. Okay. Now, let's do the next one. Here, 875 minus 429. Now, what is 5 minus 9? You cannot do 5 minus 9, so we'll borrow 1 from 7. So, this 7 becomes 6 and this 5 becomes 15. So, 15 minus 9. How much is 15 minus 9? is 6. So we'll write 6 here in 1's place. Then 6 minus 2 is how much? 6 minus 2 is 4. So we write 4. And 8 minus 4 is how much? 8 minus 4 is also 4. So we'll write 4 here. So we got 446 as the answer. Correct. So to check the answer, what we'll do? We'll write 446 here. Then we'll add it to the smallest number, which is 429. So what is the answer that we'll get? 446 plus 429. So when I add 6 plus 9, I'll get how much? I'll get 15. So we'll write 5 here and carry over 1. So we carry over 1 to 10th place. So carrying over 1 to 10th place, I have 4 plus 1, 5, and 5 plus 2, 7. Correct? So we'll write 7. Then 4 plus 4, 8. So the answer here is 875. Okay, 875. Okay, let's do one more problem now. Now, 540 minus 185. Now, I cannot do 0 minus 5, so I'll borrow 1. So, this 4 becomes 3 and the 0 becomes 10. So, how much is 10 minus 5? 10 minus 5 is 5. Correct. Then, we'll do 3 minus 8. Can you do 3 minus 8? We cannot do. So, we'll borrow 1 from this 5. This 5 becomes 4 hundredths. And this 3 becomes 13. So, 13 minus 8. How much is 13 minus 8? 13 minus 8 is 5. Okay. So, we'll write 5. Then, 4 minus 1 is 3. So, the answer is 355. Now, here to check our answer, we will write 355 plus 185. So, what you'll get? 5 plus 5, we get 10. Okay, 5 plus 5, we get the answer as 10. So, we'll write 0 here and carry over 1. Okay, so 5 plus 1, 6 and 6 plus 8, 14. So, we write 4 here and carry over 1. So, 1 plus 3, 4 and 4 plus 1, 2. So, the answer, 3 plus 1, 4 and 4 plus 1, 5. Correct? So, the answer is 540, not 240, it is 540. Okay, so 540 is the correct answer here. So, this you get 540 only as the answer. Okay, I hope you understood how to do. Now, these last two questions, you'll have to try on your own and do it for homework. So, these two questions and then these three questions over here are for your homework. So, complete your homework and in the next class, we will continue with subtraction stories. Okay, we'll do subtraction stories in the next class. Alright, thank you students. I'll see you all in the next class.